Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdale here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in previous presentations, I introduced a way of using Euler's formula to prove some trig identities. And this video focuses on an example centered around those ideas. So let me share my screen with you and we can start. Okay, so we're asked to apply this identity, which links sine with the exponential. Remember, I here is the imaginary unit, so I squared equals negative one. So apply this identity to express sine theta to the power 5 in terms of sine theta, sine 2 theta, sine 3 theta, etc. Now, before we start the actual solution for this, where does this come from? Well, it comes from Euler's formula, and I discussed this in a previous video. So you can use this and say this to come up with both of these expressions. And if I replace theta with, say, n theta, where n's an integer, you have these expressions too, which are going to be useful in our calculations and simplifications. Okay, so let's get down to business. Let's basically apply this to get this in terms of this. Okay, so let's start with, say, star, and I want sine theta all to the power 5. So let's take the both sides all to the raise them to the power 5. Okay, so from star, we have the following. So basically, I'm just taking both sides to the power 5. And let's try to simplify this. We're going to have to expand it. Let me just switch to a different colored pen for a second because this one's about to run out. Now, I can expand the top part using Pascal's triangle. The bottom part can just be sort of moved out the front to and taken to the power 5. So 2 to the power 5 is 32. I to the power 5. Okay, so I squared equals negative 1. I to the power 4 will equal negative 1 times negative 1. So that'll be 1. So if I bring this out the front, I'll get 1 on 32 times I, okay, because I to the power 5 is just I. Okay, so how do I expand this? I've got rid of that little bit there. Let's use Pascal's triangle. Okay, so Pascal's triangle is something that you would learn at high school, and it tells you the coefficients for this type of expansion. So you start with this, you add the numbers to get the corresponding sort of numbers below, and you just keep going down till you've got down to the row that you want to get down to. Okay, so this is squared, cubed, power 4, we want power 5, so the next one. Okay, so these will be our coefficients. All right, so let's expand this out and see how we go. Okay, so I've got this 1 on 32i, which I'm going to leave alone. So this raised to the power 5, so that will be e to the I theta all to the power 5, and then using my exponent or index laws, if you like, it'll be e to the I 5 theta. Okay, now what you do is you decrease the power on this and you increase the power on this and you use this coefficient up here. So I'm going to get 5 times e to the I theta all to the power 4, which is that, times this to the power 1. Okay, and I'll simplify this later. Then I'll move on to the next one, so the coefficient's 10. So instead of having power 4 associated with this, it'll be power 3. So when I do that and use the exponent laws, it'll be e to the I 3 theta times all of this to the power 2. Okay, you're increasing that. So this will then be, I'm squaring all this so that the negative will become a positive. E to the negative I theta will become, all squared will become e to the negative I 2 theta. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So it's 10 again. So instead of having a 3 here, we'll have a 2 because that's going to decrease. And here you're going to get, we're cubing this, so there will be a negative sign there. And you'll get e to the negative I 3 theta. Okay. And lastly, we've got 5 here. So this will become decreased by 1, e to the I theta, and we'll be taking negative e to the negative I theta all to the power 4. So the negative sign will disappear, and you'll be left with e to the negative I 4 theta. And lastly, this will be taken all to the power 5. So you will get your negative sign back, and you'll get something like that. Okay, so I've done that reasonably efficiently in one sort of line. You could take more than one line to do that. It just depends how familiar you are with Pascal's triangle and the algorithms. Okay, all right, so if we, so let's do one more simplification here. So I've got e to the I 5 theta. Well, I can team that up with this guy, and I'll show you why that's important in a minute. So I've taken those out. What about in here? If I do my index laws, I'll get, or exponent laws, I'll get e to the I 3 theta out of this, and with a minus sign. So I'll get this. And over here, I'll get e to the negative I 3 theta. Okay, so they're taken care of. The tens, well, they'll team up as well. If I simplify these exponents, I'll just be left with an I theta up there and a negative I theta up there. So I can actually simplify that. So that's going to give me 10 e to the I theta. And this one's going to be negative 10 e to the negative I theta. Okay. Now, why have I teamed these up together? Well, you'll see that is almost the same as cos 5 theta. I'm just missing the division by 2. Okay. And this is essentially just almost the negative of 5 times sine theta. So this is almost sine 5 theta. This is almost sine 3 theta. And this is almost sine theta. Okay, so that's almost sine theta, 5 theta, that's almost sine 3 theta, and that's almost sine theta. So if I distribute, say, 2i from here in there, I'll get pretty much exactly what I want here. So all right, so there we go. So that now is exactly sine 5 theta, okay, from here with n equals 5. That is sine 3 theta, and that is just sine theta. So now I can actually write sine theta to the power 5 in terms of these sort of parts. Okay, so I've got sine 5 theta minus 5 times sine 3 theta plus 10 times sine theta. Okay, so we want this in terms of all this. Let's actually write a conclusion then. Okay, so I guess if I want to, I can distribute this in. And the common factor of 2. And there we have it. Okay, so a good question here is, why would I want to do that? Why would I want to express this in terms of these things here? Well, one way of motivating these kinds of problems is through integration. So I know we're working with complex numbers here, but you can use these ideas in integration. Let's say you were asked to integrate this sine theta all to the power 5 with respect to theta. Now, it's not short to do this, but if you know that you can express sine to the power 5 in terms of these things are easy to integrate. Okay, you can integrate term by term and do it in essentially one line here. So that's one of the motivations for using these kinds of identities. Okay. Okay, so that's my presentation. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it useful. If you have any comments, any questions, any suggestions, feedback, you can always put them in the comment section. Thanks a lot for watching. And I hope you can join me for my next presentation on complex numbers. Hope to see you soon. Bye.